On this edition of the Black Crayon, we're going to discuss how to treat your haters. Before I start, this video is not for the people with imaginary haters. This just isn't for those people who pretend like they have haters. This is for the people who are ambitious. This is for the people who are on their grind and are leaving people behind. This is for the people who are on their way to the top and don't know how to treat the people in their life who aren't doing the same things as them. Okay, so I remind myself of what I'm about to share almost every day so that I can kind of maintain my composure and deal with the people who don't agree with the way I'm doing things. Imagine you live in a building and you live on the 13th floor. The 13th floor, it's a penthouse. Nice stuff. Flat screen TV, you got a washer dryer in there. I mean, it's everything you want. So you get into an elevator, it's full of people. All the buttons in the elevator are already pressed, 1 through 13, so you don't have to press anything. It's crunk in this elevator, a lot of people in the elevator talking, laughing, this, that, the third. Second and third floor people start getting off the elevator, fourth floor people get off. Fifth floor, a lot of people get off the elevator and they kind of starting to look like, you know, why ain't y'all getting off? Sixth floor hits, huge group of people get off the elevator and they are turned. They laughing, they joking, they dancing, and they looking at everybody else in the elevator like, why aren't you getting off? Why ain't you coming to the sixth floor? Everybody's on the sixth floor. It's what we're all doing. And it's almost like a little, should I get off on the sixth floor? You know, seventh and eighth floor, people get off. Ninth and tenth floor, some more people get off. All these people who have gotten off from seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth floor, they're kind of looking at you funny, like with a little bit of disbelief. Now, when the ninth and tenth floor people get off the elevator, you see a transition in the mind state of the people who are left on the elevator with you. The 11th and 12th and 13th floor people who are still in the elevator, they think a little differently. The 11th and 12th floor people, they recognize that you've put in work. They're familiar with the type of accommodations that are in your room. They're not there yet, but they peeping game. Now you remember that the 13th floor button was already pressed. So after the 11th and the 12th floor people get off the elevator, it's just you and one more person. That person is your new best friend. Okay, this sounds good. Here are a couple of the urges that you have to fight. You should never, ever, ever, ever fall victim to the sixth floor turn up. They are never going to understand the type of life you live. They're never going to understand why you weren't content with the sixth floor, and you can never explain it to them. How do you explain the perks of having a high definition television to someone who's okay with having basic cable? You can't. If this person is content with sixth floor living, let them be content with sixth floor living. We all have friends and associates who've fallen victim to the sixth floor turn up. They're complacent. They're satisfied with mediocrity. They don't think there's anything better than where they are right now. Let them stay there. The people who you have to keep around you are the people who are on the 11th, 12th, and the 13th floor. These people understand what it takes to get to the top. They're never content. They're never satisfied. They're always working. They're always trying to get something better. They live a penthouse lifestyle. That's you. It is so easy for us to get caught up in wanting to gain the approval of those stuck in the sixth floor turn up mind state. We have to let it go. You have to remind yourself that there's a reason you're on the 13th floor. There's a reason you worked this hard. You were there. You were on the sixth floor. That wasn't enough for you, so you grinded until you got to the top. You're gonna leave a lot of people behind when you're doing your thing, and that's okay. You have to remind yourself why you're doing what you're doing and stay true to the penthouse lifestyle that got you where you are in the first place. That's how you treat your haters. We can't forget, I own a clothing line, Attain Asterism. This is the metal snapback, and this is the new Attain Asterism Reach Tee. You should definitely make sure you cop yourself one of those. There's someone you should follow in the description. There's also a link to their work. You should definitely check it out. I'd give it 3 thumbs up if I had 3 thumbs. This has been another edition of the Black Crayon. Thank you for watching.